हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सुतारन जी फ्रॉम संजीवनी कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोग्नोसी एंड फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी सी डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ एश वैल्यू। फ्रेंड्स, यू नो दैट एश वैल्यू इज समवट इम्पोर्टेंट, इज वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर विच इज यूज टू स्टडी द स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन और क्वालिटी इवेल्यूशन of a crude drug. Means if there is some what impurity is there should be present or not. If the impurity is there should be present, then that is be evaluated by this one particular experiment, that is we call it as a ash value. So what are the experiments are there, what are the parameters are there, we have to design, such as your moisture content is there, ash value is there, foreign particles are there, all these experiments are there that are to be based on the reference, that references are there that are we have to be obtained from the official books, such as your Indian Pharmacopoeia, British Pharmacopoeia, Herbal Pharmacopoeia, Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia. All these are the official books are there, in that each and every one drugs parameters along with that the standard values are there that are to be given, that are to be performed, given depends on the several times that experiments are there that is to be repeated, and what are the values are there that you obtain, that are to be mentioned, that are not exact one, that are in the range. So what are the experiment we have to be performed, that range must be in the official books, range is there. So what type of the material is there should be utilized in the as a impurity, or we can say that mixing is there, which should be done by what type of the material is there should be utilized. So that values are there that should be identified by utilizing this one experiment, that is a ash value. Okay, so here again we have to take neem leaves, dry this one neem leaves, then that neem leaves powder is there should be taken. For this experiment we have take suppose 1.5 gram of the neem leaves powder and a tiered crucible. Tiered crucible means what, whose no weight you have already taken and noted in the book. Okay, so for this one purpose we required empty crucible. In that empty crucible, we have to place 1.5 gram of the drug. Okay, then heat that one crucible and the drug on a Bunsen burner. Okay, on a blue color flame. Take note that blue color flame, just like your gas stove is there, the blue color flame is there where to be utilized, where the heat is there is maximum on a blue color flame. Okay, so heat that one particular drug unless and until there is a ash is formed. Ash means what, your gray color material is there, not a single particle of a black color is there, which indicate if the black color is there, that indicate that ash is there is not to be done completely, and somewhere the coal is there. So to have a complete ash. For the leaves, leafy material 300 degrees centigrade is there is sufficient, and if the wood part or some other parts are there that are present, so for that up to the 500 degrees centigrade temperature is sufficient to make an ash. Okay, so somewhere muffle furnace is there is also utilized to make an ash, but today we see by utilizing a Bunsen burner. Okay, so once ash is there should be formed, such color is there, whole ash is there is having same color. This you have to note down the weight of the crucible and ash after cooling. Okay, allow it to cool, and after that one you have to note down the weight. Let's move to the calculation part. Suppose you have taken 1.5 gram of the drug. From this one you are getting y gram of ash. If you have taken 100 gram of the drug, then how much quantity of the ash is obtained? That is the percentage ash value. This is your total ash is there. Okay, so we have to utilize. There are the different type of the ash values are there. First one is there, that is a acid insoluble ash. Second one, water soluble ash. Third one, sulfated ash. Let's see how acid insoluble ash is performed. Acid insoluble ash, so far the name itself indicate you there is a use of acid, not concentrated, but we have to utilize a dilute acid for this one particular experiment. Just you have to take 10 ml of the acid, okay, for this one purpose. So how to make dilute acid? Just you have to take the 50 ml of the water. To that one, you have to add 10 ml of the acid, concentrated acid. Stir it, and in that one mixture, you are going to add again some quantity of water to make up a volume up to the 100 ml. In this way, the dilute acid is there is prepared. After that one, you have to in that one dilute acid, you have to take some of the quantity of the ash. Max at max you can take 100 or 1 gram of the ash. Okay, or what is the ash you have taken? Just you have to note it, and then you have to add. Okay, then boil that one particular mixture, that is your ash and dilute HCl. After boil for 20 minute, boil for 20 minutes means once the mixture is to be started to boil, allow it to keep for 20 minutes and filter this one. Okay, after filtration, for filtration purpose, you have to utilize Wattmann filter paper, or we can say that ashless filter paper, that is we utilize. Because after what is the ashless filter paper is there, when you to burn that one paper completely, what the ash which is to be obtained is not having weight, so it's called ashless filter paper that we have to be utilized. After filtration through the ashless filter paper, just we have to collect this one particular mixture, then place that one in empty crucible. Okay, so friends, here we have to be dissolve that one particular ash in a dilute acid, because what are the materials which are to be dissolved or goes to be dissolved? That is your after the charcoal is there is we form, or what are the particles are there which are to be go solubilizes that are to be dissolved, and then that is goes into the liquid form. Here only the insoluble ash is there should be remain. So we have to check how much quantity of the acid insoluble ash is there is to be remain. So what is the ashless filter paper, or we can say that Wattmann filter paper, we have to be utilized for the filtration purpose. What is the ash which is to be remain in that one filter paper? Just we have to pull it and place it in a crucible. Okay, then heat that one particular mixture on a Bunsen burner at a blue color flame till the complete ash is formed. Here also complete ash is there should be formed. Then allow it to cool. Crucible with ash, allow it to cool here, and then take wet of that. Okay, so one part of the calculation here again, 1 gram of the ash you have taken. Here, y gram of the acid insoluble ash you have to be obtained. If 100 gram of the ash if you have taken, how much? That is the percentage acid insoluble ash value. Okay, now the next one is there, that is a water soluble ash. So friends, here we have to be, instead of the acid, dilute acid, we have to take water again here. In this case, we have to take ash, the from the total ash. Okay, You have to take some quantity of the ash. Just you have to note down that one. Again, boil it for 20 minutes and filter through the Wattmann filter paper, or we can say that ashlash filter paper. The process is again same. Take an empty crucible, tear empty crucible. Then in that you have to place this one mixture, that is ashlash filter paper plus your water insoluble ash. Okay. Heat it again till the complete ash is there, is we form. Then allow it to cool. Then note down weight. This weight is there is of the water insoluble ash. So we require water soluble ash, weight of the water soluble ash. So 1 gram of the ash, if you have to take on from this one, you are getting the y gram of the water insoluble ash. So how much is the water soluble ash? So for that one purpose, if you have taken, what is the, what much quantity of the total ash is there you are taken for this one examine. From this one, how much quantity of the water insoluble ash is remain? So if you have to remove this one, you are getting the water soluble ash. Let's we see its y1. Okay. So 1 gram of the ash, if you have to be taken, you are getting the y1 gram of the water soluble ash. So if 100 gram of the ash you are taken, so how much quantity of the water soluble ash you have to be obtained? Just by cross multiplication, 100 into y1. Instead of y, just consider y1 divided by 1. That is a percentage water soluble ash. So friends, if you are new to this one channel, request you to subscribe my channel and give likes to this one video. Thank you.